interested in where these particles came from. He was more interested, I feel, in the sort of thing that Professor Soskin was telling us about earlier, about the way the ionization varied in the atmosphere, you know, with heights and with time of day and so on and so on. And I think, again, this sort of narrowness versus breadth comes into it. But in a sense, it is a bit surprising. And I wonder to what extent Hess read the literature, because I mentioned in Italy, in fact, it's surprising when Hess, an atmospheric electrician, found this result, something that's coming from above, why he didn't say, oh, that's interesting, it's to do with what we now call the ionosphere. Wasn't called that then, but it was known that there was ionization, electrically charged particles up there. They were detected in a way by Marconi and Popov. In Russia, they allowed a transmission. If it had been me, I would have said, oh, it's, you know, atmospheric electricity, yes, there's plenty of ionization up there, there's something leaking down. But such was the greatness of this man, the lateral, or rather the vertical, thinking. He said, no, it's coming from outside the atmosphere. Brilliant.